Tell me a little bit about just your relationship with him and how special a broadcaster he's been for you in learning this career for you.
Yeah, I think, I mean, it's hard to put into words how much he's meant to my second career. I know it wouldn't have got off to the start it did without him sitting next to me. I mean, his ability to do his job was as good as anyone ever seen. And then, I mean, he could steer a conversation, he could have fun, he could get us back on track. His timing, his understanding of situations, everything he did, he was a true professional. And I think it's a tough day that I think you never know when it's going to come, but it comes for everybody. I mean, whether it's in your playing days or your broadcasting days, and I think it's a tough day. I think for all Twins fans who grew up with his voice in their living room, and you know, he's a historian of the team. I mean, so many things well, and I think it's a tough day for all of us who work alongside of him.
What made him special, Justin, in the movie? What is it about him? It's not just his voice. What is it about him?
Well, I think he prepares. I think it's going to be hard for whoever sits in that seat next to love the Minnesota Twins and love the game of baseball as much as Dick does. I think his passion for the team and his passion for the job, it's something that you respect so much because of how much he loved what he did and how much he sat in that chair. And I don't think he ever took, he was closing in on 5,000 games, but I don't think he ever took one of those, you know, 4,900 plus games for granted. Every day that he got to call a Twins game, that he was doing his dream job. And I think that's what made him so good, was his passion from the first game of the year to the last game of the year. In a year when you win 100 games or a year where you lose 100 games, he approached it the same way every single day with a level of passion that's going to be hard for anyone to match.
Tell me about the night that you guys gave him the cake, because he got pretty emotional.
Yeah, I think we had no idea what was going to happen after the year, but you know, he missed the home opener with COVID, so we never got a chance to celebrate him, I think, in a way that we felt we should have. So the year was winding down. Ploofy and I looked at each other when we were out for dinner. We said, hey, we have to do something tomorrow. We have to give him something, you know, just to acknowledge the fact that to last 40 years in this game with a whole bunch of teams is an accomplishment, but to last 40 years with the same team with the same amount of passion from 1983 to, you know, 2023 is something that I'm not sure few human beings could do. And he did it. And we felt like, you know, we just want to recognize that. And then, you know, I've seen him get him a couple of times, but never on the air. And the fact that we, you know, we surprised him and you know, we felt like it was just a sign of respect. You know, players at the end of their career, a lot of times, you know, you have that moment like Joe had walking off the field, tip your cap to the crowd. And we felt like we just wanted to make sure that he had some type of moment, and he'll get that moment as well coming up. Hopefully, he did into the Twins Hall of Fame. But yeah, we felt like it was the right thing to do at the right time.
Critics would say that he was too much of a homer. Do you think he was too much of a homer?
I don't think there is such a thing. I mean, you think of it. I think Hawk Harrelson's the guy in Chicago who made it okay to cheer for your own team and still be the broadcaster. I think you want to have. You want to be fair. You can be critical. I think and we have the ability to do that, but with reason. And I think there's nothing wrong with sitting there watching a game, because now we, you know, I see it from the other side. I watch a national game. You know, Fox picks up our Saturday game or Apple or whoever picks it up, and then we're sitting at home going, oh, we know so much more about our team, and we maybe it's biased, but at the same time, you know, we like our guys. You build a relationship with those guys. I think that's the part. Maybe speaking for him right now, but I mean, I think that's the part he's going to miss as much as anything, is that interaction, the knowledge of, you know, Caleb Philbar and going hunting with him, or his relationship with Kent Hrbek, or just all the players who have come through, and especially the Minnesota kids that, you know, he took as much pride of them putting on a Twins uniform as he did. So I think it was okay. Everyone was okay with it. At least we were okay with it, because we knew that it came from his heart and it came from a good
I
place.
was going to ask you, what do you think he'll miss the most?
Yeah, I think I'm not sure he's going to miss getting off the plane at 4 a.m. in Houston, or you know, the grind of all that stuff. But at the same time, the preparation, you know, waking up in the morning, I think, you know, understanding that we got Kershaw coming in, and you know, we took a perfect game into the seventh the last time he was there, or we got, you know, some of these legends that he always appreciated. I think he's going to miss that part of it. But I think I learned going over to the TV side that the people in the booth, the people, the camera operators, the sound, the people in the truck, there's these relationships that you have. And in a lot of the cities you go to, it's people who have been there for 20, 25 years. And everywhere we went, he seemed to know, the security guard at the entrance, and he knew the camera operator, he knew everybody, and there was a relationship there, and going back a long time for a lot of these people. And I think that's as much as anything. And I think that's the thing that is going to be hard for him. Not going through those cities, not going through Oakland, not going through Anaheim, and just the chance to say, hey, hopefully I see you next year. We know that there's not going to be a next year for that. And that's unfortunate, but those people have fond memories of Dick and the way he approached his job and the way he did things.
Last question. How would you summarize his legacy as a Twins broadcaster?
Well, I think he's seen so many big moments. He's a historian of the franchise. He can recall, a pitching matchup that happened in 1986, or he can recall, where he was in the World Series. He knows so much about the game. And I think that's the thing, as much as anything, that he had this uncanny ability to be in the middle of a conversation and all of a sudden something would pop into his head, a memory, a player, someone who maybe only spent a few months with the team, and be able to kind of jump back into that and bring you back to saying, oh, I remember Terry Tiffey. I remember, Matt Tolbert playing for us. He can tell you who won game 163. He can tell you so much about the game. And I think we're going to miss that, but that's part of his legacy. And I think people will remember from the time they were when they were kids, hearing his voice in their living room when they were eating dinner, he was part of so many people's lives growing up. He impacted them in a positive way, and he was a voice for the team for so many years. And I think we're going to miss that voice because it's legendary. And I think whoever has to fill that seat is going to have some big shoes to fill. But it's going to be a different day, opening day without Dick there sitting next to me, but he'll be watching and he'll be cheering.
I take it that you didn't have any idea at the end of the season that this might be a possibility.
No, I mean, with all the kind of the turmoil in the industry with the TV contracts, and we knew that our contract was up with Bally, but nobody really knew what it was going to look like moving forward. And I think that's the challenge of it is, he didn't get a chance to say goodbye. He will at Target Field, but I think nobody really knows even what the next couple of weeks are going to look like, who's going to be broadcasting Twins games and everything else. So I think there was so much uncertainty at the end of the year that, as we said, with the cake and the presentation, we wanted to make sure he was acknowledged for his 40 years of being tremendous at his job and being the number one fan in Twins territory.